indeed, I have no need of you. On the contrary, the parts of the body that seem to be weaker are indispensable, and on those parts of the body that we think less honorable, we bestow the greater honor, and our unpresentable parts are treated with greater modesty, which our more presentable parts do not require. But God has so composed the body, giving greater honor to the part that lacked it, that there may be no division in the body, but that the members may have the same care for one another. If one member suffers, all suffer together. If one member is honored, all rejoice together. Now you are the body of Christ and individually members of it. And God has appointed in the church first apostles, second prophets, third teachers, then miracles, then gifts of healing, helping, administrating, and various kinds of tongues. Are all apostles? Are all prophets? Are all teachers? Do all work miracles? Do all possess gifts of healing? Do all speak with tongues? Do all interpret? But earnestly desire the higher gifts. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We continue now with singing Jesus Loves the Little Children. For the reading of the Holy Gospel. The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the fourth chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus came to Nazareth, where he had been brought up. And as was his custom, he went to the synagogue on the Sabbath day, and he stood up to read. And the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was given to him. He unrolled the scroll and found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because he has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim liberty to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who are oppressed, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." And he rolled up the scroll and gave it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all in the synagogue were fixed on him. And he began to say to them, "Today the scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." And all spoke well of him and marveled at the gracious words that were coming from his mouth. And they said, "Is this not Joseph's son?" And he said to them, "Doubtless you will quote to me this proverb, 'Physician, heal yourself.' What we have heard you did at Capernaum, do here in your hometown as well." And he said, "Truly I say to you, no prophet is acceptable in his hometown. But in truth, I tell you, There were many widows in Israel in the days of Elijah, when the heavens were shut up 3 years and 6 months, and a great famine came over all the land. And Elijah was sent to none of them, only to Zarephath in the land of Sidon, to a woman who was a widow. And there were many lepers in Israel in the time of the prophet Elisha, and none of them was cleansed, but only Naaman the Syrian. When they heard these things, all in the synagogue were filled with wrath, and they rose up and drove him out of the town and brought him to the brow of the hill on which their town was built, so that they could throw him down the cliff. But passing through their midst, he went away. This is the gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. We have a great, great story here. Jesus is speaking in his hometown. People are positive towards Jesus. But Jesus knows why they're positive. They think the miracle boy will do some miracles for them. After all, they've got a claim on him. They are his hometown homeboys. Physician, heal thyself means, hey, take care of your own. We are your own. We people of Nazareth. Your dad was one of us, and you're one of us. So do us a solid and do some miracles for us. But Jesus ruffles their feathers. He says, there is one thing that is definitely true for all prophets. They are never welcomed in their hometown. Then he goes on. What is not necessarily true for prophets is this. They don't have to do miracles for their hometown homeboys. In fact, they sometimes don't do miracles for their fellow Jews at all. And then he recognizes some of those prophets in the Old Testament. Check out the prophet Elijah. He did great miracles for who? For a poor widow. Not in the nation of Israel, but in Sidon. She was the widow from Zarephath. She was not just an out-of-towner. She was an out-of-countryer. And then he says, same thing goes for Elisha. His great healing, his great miracle of healing leprosy was not done for somebody in his hometown. It was not even done for any Israelite at all. It was done for Naaman the Syrian. Jesus is saying, it cannot be insisted that I do anything for you based on hometown ties. Nobody, in fact, can insist that Jesus do anything. Nobody is ever to believe that Jesus owes them anything. You cannot make any claims on Jesus. Your status among people won't help you. Your power won't help you. Your riches won't help you either. Your position in society, your works won't even help you. I could right now come up with a serum to cure all COVIDs and its different mutations. But God wouldn't owe me anything for that. People might praise me, but God doesn't owe me anything. Even if your works are the most impressive works imaginable, Jesus does not respond to obligation. Unless, of course, out of grace, he has obligated himself in his word. Once again, I'm going to say that. God does not go to human obligation. However, he does obligate himself out of grace in his word. What he promises, he follows through. Jesus will answer prayer. But not because you prayed the right thing, not because your prayers were the proper length, not because you said the right words, but because he is gracious, and in his grace, he has promised to do that. We hear in Scripture that The Lord will take care of you and will never leave you. Not because you attended St. John for 30 years, not because of great military service. God will take care of you because out of grace, he has promised to do so. He removes your sins as far as the east is from the west. Not because you impressed him. Not because of your bloodline. But because of his grace. He shed his blood for you. He comes to you in his body and blood. And this Wednesday we're having the Lord's Supper service at 6. He comes to you in his body and blood. Not because your pastor is holy. But because Jesus is so gracious and has the power to do so. And he said he will in his word. Take and eat, this is my body. Take and drink, this is my blood. God never owes, but he does give. And he gives out of grace. And he gives according to his word. Never make any claims on Christ apart from God's word, apart from his grace. But this one claim is safe. Lord Jesus, you have bought me with your blood. You've declared me your brother. I am yours, and you are mine. Take care of me. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We continue by confessing our faith in our Savior in the words of the Apostles' Creed. Please rise.